Daily Morning Prayer, Friday, December 8th, 2023. In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by His infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in His presence, to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at His hands, declare His most worthy praise, to hear His holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. We grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may not only be godly, righteous, and sober life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. God, to your people, merciful, and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was at the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Our King and Savior now draws near. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you land. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God, it is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. Our King and Savior now draws near. O come, let us adore him. Rebuke me not, O God, in your anger, neither chasten me in your weighty displeasure. For your arrows stick fast in me, and your hands presses me hard. There is no health in my flesh because of your displeasure, neither is there any rest in my bones by reason of my sin. For my iniquities have gone over my head and are like a heavy burden, too much for me to bear. My wounds fester, stink and fester by reason of my foolishness. I am brought into such great trouble and misery that I go about mourning all the day long. For my loins are filled with burning, and there is no wholeness in my body. I am feeble and sorely smitten. I have roared because of the tumult of my heart. Lord, you know all my desire and my groaning is not hidden from you. My heart is panting. My strength has failed me, and the sight of my eyes has gone from me. My friends and my neighbors turn away from my trouble, and my kinsmen stand afar off. Those also who seek after my life lay snares for me, and those who go about to do me evil talk of wickedness and imagine deceit all the day long. As for me, I am like the deaf who do not hear, and as one who is mute who does not open his mouth. I have become like a man who hears not, and in whose mouth are no reproof. For in you, O Lord, have I put my trust. You shall answer for me, O Lord my God. I have said, let not my enemies triumph over me. But when my foot slipped, they rejoiced greatly over me. Truly, I am about to fall, and my pain is ever with me. For I will confess my wickedness and be sorry for my sin. But my enemies live and are mighty, and those who hate me wrongfully are many in number. Those also who repay evil for good are against me, because I follow that which is good. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, O be not far from me. Make haste to help me, O Lord God of my salvation. I said, I will take heed to my ways, that I may not offend with my tongue. I will keep my mouth as with a bridle while the ungodly are in my sight. I held my tongue and spoke nothing. I kept silence even from good words, but it was pain and grief to me. My heart was hot within me, and while I was thus pondering, the fire kindled, and at the last I spoke with my tongue. Lord, let me know my end and the number of my days, that I may learn how short my life is. Behold, you have made my days as a span in length, and my age is even as nothing before you, and truly everyone living is but a breath. For everyone walks about as a shadow and disquiets himself in vain. He heaps up riches and cannot tell who shall gather them. And now, Lord, what is my hope? Truly, my hope is in you. Deliver me from all my offenses and make me not a taunt of the foolish. I became mute and opened not my mouth, for it was you that brought it to pass. Take your affliction from me. I am consumed by the blows of your heavy hand. When you, with rebukes, chasten someone for sin, you consume what is dear to him, like a moth eating a garment. Everyone, therefore, is but vanity. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and with your ears consider my cry. Hold on your peace at my tears. For I am a stranger with you and a sojourner, as all my fathers were. O turn your gaze from me, that I may again be glad, before I go away to be seen no more. I waited patiently for the Lord. He inclined to me and heard my call. He brought me out of the horrible pit, out of the clay. He set my feet upon the rock and secured my footing. He has put a new song in my mouth, a song of thanksgiving unto our God. Many shall see and fear, and shall put their trust in the Lord. Blessed is the man who has set his hope in the Lord and has not turned to the proud or to those who go about lying. O Lord my God, great are the wondrous works which you have done, and also your thoughts toward us. There is none who can be compared with you. If I should declare them and speak of them, they would be more than I am able to express. Sacrifice and offering you do not desire. But my ears you have opened. Burnt offerings and sin offerings you have not required. And so I said, behold, I come. In the volume of the book, it is written of me that I delight to do your will, O my God. Indeed, your law is written within my heart. I have declared your righteousness in the great congregation. Behold, I will not restrain my lips, O Lord, and that you know. I have not hidden your righteousness within my heart. A talk has been of your truth and of your salvation. I have not concealed your loving mercy and truth from the great congregation. Withdraw not your mercy from me, O Lord. Let your loving kindness and your truth always preserve me. For innumerable troubles have encompassed me. My sins have taken such hold of me that I am not able to look up. Indeed, they are more numerous than the hairs of my head, and my heart has utterly failed me. Lord, let it be your pleasure to deliver me. Make haste, O Lord, to help me. Let them be ashamed and confounded to seek after my soul, to destroy it. Let them be driven backward and rebuked. Wish me evil. Let them be desolate and rewarded with shame who say to me, aha. Let all those who seek you be joyful and glad in you, and let those who love your salvation say, always the Lord be praised. As for me, I am poor and needy, but the Lord cares for me. You are my helper and deliverer. Tarry, O my God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was at the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the evil ones their thoughts. And let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion, and to our God, for he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens, and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing and bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have purposed and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was at the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. A reading from the Revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ to St. John. Beginning with the first chapter, the first verse, the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show to his bondservants the things which must soon take place. And he sent and communicated it by his angel to his bondservant, John, who testified to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ. everything that he saw. Blessed is the one who reads and those who hear the words of the prophecy and keep the things which are written in it, for the time is near. John to the seven churches that are in Asia. Grace to you and peace from him who is, and who was, and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth, to him who loves us and released us from our sins by his blood. And he made us into a kingdom of priests to his God and Father. To him be the glory and the dominion forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth will mourn over him. So it is to be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. I, John, your brother and fellow participant in the tribulation and kingdom and perseverance in Jesus, was on the island called Patmos because of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud voice, like the sound of a trumpet, saying, write on a scroll what you see, and send it to the seven churches, to Ephesus, to Smyrna, to Samira, Pergamon, Thyatira, Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea. Then I turned to see the voice that was speaking with me. And after turning, I saw seven golden lampstands. And in the middle of the lampstands, I saw one like a son of man, clothed in a robe reaching to the feet, and wrapped around the chest with a golden sash. His head and his hair were white, like white wool, like snow. And his eyes were like a flame of fire. His feet were like burnished bronze when it has been heated to a glow in a furnace. And his voice was like the sound of many waters. In his right hand he held seven stars, and out of his mouth came a sharp two-edged sword. And his face was like the sun shining in its strength. When I saw him, I fell at his feet like a dead man. And he placed his right hand on me, saying, do not be afraid. I am the first and the last, and the living one. And I was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And I have the keys of death and of Hades. Therefore, write the things which you have seen, and the things which are, and the things which will take place after these things. As for the mystery of the seven stars which you saw in my right hand, and the seven golden lampstands, the seven stars are the angels of the seven churches, and the seven lampstands are the seven churches. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain. For with your blood you have redeemed for God from every family, language, people, and nation, and kingdom, and priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion, and splendor forever and forevermore. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light now in the time of this mortal life in which your Son Jesus Christ came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to joy, but he first suffered pain, and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone works great marvels, send down upon our clergy and the congregations committed to their charge the life-giving spirit of your grace. Shower them and the with the continual dew of your blessing, and ignite in them a zealous love of your gospel. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all we have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised, through your well-beloved Son, that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.